And then don't look at your paper again. Just look at the line of where the buildings are outlined by the sea or outlined by the sky. Follow the trees, the buildings. Okay. So you could, if you start with the trees, you could then do the next line.
These are looking good.
These are looking good. Repeat something in sound. So if I do this, what do you call that?
Following the shapes. Taking a journey through the space. These are looking really, really good. But there isn't a right or a wrong way, and I'm really interested to see how it
is. Also creating an abstract form. So you've got the geometry, the shape, the rectangular shape of the buildings, and then these more organic shapes in between. And it creates an abstract interpretation rather than a figurative interpretation. Figurative is when something looks more photographically real. Outside shape. In between things, check to see if your picture's right.
And some blue and some white.
Give you a bit of that contrast.
Okay. Should I do black?
Yeah,
you could end up with that being the negative into the space.
Everyone go. Keep them held up. Okay, now just lower them down a bit so you can look at everyone else's. The octopus from Madagascar 3. Dave! You ever seen Madagascar 3?
No.
Oh, you should, it's the funniest.
Oh! Yes, I drew the flying pug.
Who drew that? That's amazing. Just
in the middle of nowhere, Trump. That's all I can.
Maybe the guy about the.
Wait,
shall we take the first photo? What do you need? Because there's lots of stuff here.
Paper.
Yeah.
What are we doing
there? Well, there's a forest, which is on the top.
I know, I know. There's a mini handbag next to it.
Why did you make it so
big?
like the walk. Go by walk.
The cocoon's over there being dipped and split by one of the MA students. We've got some glaze tests, testing different coloured glazes.
How well has worked? A short load outside. So when you've got your plaster, that will make a lot of dust. So can you feel it's thickening up as well? This goes quite quick. So let me have it back now then. Hold it on. It's not just pull your gloves off now. You can wash it off.
Actually,
I think
it's going to be
okay.
It's going to
so quick, get it. You need to push it all in so it doesn't run right. Well, check around the bin now, right there, when you go back out.
Okay?
Oh, no, it's so, do you want it any more than a
ton?
A little bit more.
Is it done?
No, still a bit longer to go.
Okay.
So just level that out then. That's it. So just now, if you take it down to the bowl at the other end. So carefully peel it off. If you tip it up the other way, so you can see, that's yours, is it? Yours. And then all the clay, we'll have the clay back and we'll use that this afternoon.
Thank you.
So, where's yours? Whose was this one then? This is Alex. Can you see what I mean now about the where you push it in? It does the opposite. Yeah. What do you think?
I like. I'm gonna paint the fingernails. It's gonna be super.
That you can pull your thumb out of. So, go on.
Put your hand in. Have a feel, mix it in for me. Take turns.
So then start to wiggle your finger gently. And eventually you'll see.
Come on.
Come on.
Ow.
It's 10 past 5.
Ah, there you go.
Finished pieces.
Yeah.
And I'll just constantly make the pasta.
Sounds good. Yeah, I really don't think I can.
No. If it comes off in one piece. I can't do it now, everybody's watching. See, it just tears off. Like that. And then you can get your thumb out. So that's not a little thumb, is it? So that's